This video will show how to use real-time fit factor display. Real-time fit factor display puts the port account into direct measurement mode without running fit test exercises. Using this mode, a test subject will know if they have an adequate fit in about 30 seconds. This is a great tool to train a respirator user how to properly adjust a respirator to help determine what size respirator an individual should use before you start a fit test. Let's take a look at how it works. I have two fit respirators set up, prepared for fit testing. I have a full face respirator with a fit test adapter, and I have an N95 filtering face piece respirator probed for fit testing. Ben will put this on and demonstrate how real-time mode can help learn how to adjust the respirator. So I'm using a port account in standalone mode. I've already completed the daily check. I've connected the clear sample tube to the fit test adapter and the other end of the twin tube to the respirator. From the activity screen, I simply hit real-time and it starts into real-time mode. So as Ben's making his adjustments, the instrument is doing an ambient measurement like in a fit test, and then it's going to measure from inside the respirator, and we'll get a display measured here pretty soon, and we're looking for the displayed line to stabilize above 500. For this respirator, we want a fit factor of 500. So as Ben has the mask on and adjusted, I've started the real-time mode. It's taking an ambient sample, then it samples from the mask like it does with a fit test, but it's not following a protocol this time, it's just doing it in real time. And our ambient levels are good, and now it's gonna take a mask sample, and then it will calculate what a fit factor would be, and it will draw a line on the graph. With this mask, we want a fit factor of 500. It should draw that line above 500, and if we keep that line stabilized above 500, we know we have a good fit. So our line is above 1,000. You see this moving in real time. That shows that the mask he has on fits well and it's properly adjusted. He has a good fit. It's going to do what it's supposed to do. So to demonstrate how quickly this measures, once you break the seal, put your finger through the facepiece seal and break the seal real quick and let go. And we'll watch the screen change within a few seconds. It drops way down and then it will recover. So it shows if there is a leak in the mask, it's going to display that and show that. It drops down and then it comes back quickly. So when we get back above 500, we know we have a good fit. Right now we're at 200, 300, and now we're above 500. So that's how we would use it for fit testing a full face mask. Now let's demonstrate this using an N95 filtering face piece respirator. Again, I connect the clear sample port to the probe on the N95 mask. While Ben puts the mask on, I'm gonna check to make sure I have my port account set in N95 enabled mode, and I'm gonna hit restart. So it's gonna do an ambient count, then it'll start doing a mask count, and it'll start to calculate a fit factor. With this type of mask, we're looking to achieve a fit factor of 100. With these folding filtering face piece masks, properly molding that metal strip over your nose is critical to providing a good fit. So using a tool like the real-time fit factor display is a great way for Ben to learn how to adjust that and make that fit his face the best way possible and get some real-time feedback. So we don't have to take the whole 7 minutes of a fit test. We'll know right away here in a couple seconds whether it fits or not. So we have a line starting out in a fit factor of 50, so we know we're not achieving our 100. So as he continues to make adjustments, maybe move the strap up higher on your head and smooth it out over your nose a little bit better. Now that number jumps way up. So the adjustments he just made over his nose jumps way up above 100, and we're maxed out at 200 plus. So he just found a way to make that fit properly. So now we know we have a mask that fits, it's adjusted properly, and now we can go into the fit testing exercises. So I want to emphasize the real-time fit factor mode does not take the place of a fit test. So it doesn't follow the exercises like an OSHA protocol. But as we've shown, using a real-time fit factor display, this is a valuable tool. We can train a new user how to adjust the respirator. In a similar fashion, we can use this to quickly evaluate whether we have the right size for that individual before they take the time of doing a fit test. So another use of this real-time fit factor display is troubleshooting a failed test. So if Ben had just finished a fit test and he failed the fit test, I would have him leave the mask on, go into real-time mode, and watch the screen as we do the same adjustments and make the adjustments on the respirator to understand what has to change to make that respirator fit better. If you can't get a good fit, maybe it's not the right size mask. We'll try a different size mask. So to wrap up, real-time fit factor display, it's not a substitute for a fit test because it doesn't follow the established protocol. The real-time fit factor display is a great tool. can help identify the right size respirator to use. We can use it to train how to properly adjust this respirator, and it's a good tool to use to troubleshoot a failed fit test. See you next time.